Hello student, myself Professor Gada Keses from S&T College of Engineering and Research Center, Evra. Student, we are learning the final year subject, that is the solar and wind energy. From that unit number unit number 4 we are learning, that is the case study on the solar energy application. Particularly, solar energy is used in the so many fields. But in the unit number 4, we have to generally study the three case study of the solar energy. First case study is related to the study and design of solar food dryers. Second case study is related to the solar parabolic dish cooker. All of you understand? And third case study is related to the solar photovoltaic system. Now, up to the last lecture, we have seen some topics from the third case study. That means before that also, we have studied the two case study. First case study, solar food dryer, and second case study, that is a parabolic dish solar cooker. Now, up to the last lecture, we have seen some topics from the unit number, from case study number 3, that is the solar photovoltaic system also. So, let's see which topic we have seen. Now here case study number 2 is written, sorry, but that's points we mentioned below, that's are related to the case study number 3, that is the solar photovoltaic system. So what is the solar photovoltaic system, that also we have discussed. Then how would the photovoltaic system works, that also we have discussed. Photovoltaic system components, all the types, that also we have discussed. Now remaining point, that is the photovoltaic effect, that we have to learn in the today's lecture. So in the details, before that also I have explained you photovoltaic effect, but that I have explained you in the short. Now in the today's lecture we are going to see in the details what is the photovoltaic effects. Now related to the photovoltaic effect, theory is given, but before that I want to show you one diagram so that you will easily understand how the photovoltaic effect will happen. So process of photovoltaic effect, for that diagram, process of photovoltaic effect, that name is given. That means what? How the photovoltaic effect is done, that shown in the diagram. Now if you are able to see here, there are two components. First solar panel is shown and sun is shown. Now from the sun, sunlight is receiving to the solar panel. That means what? From the sun, sunlight is receiving means what? In the sunlight, there will be the photons. Sunlight contains the bunch of the photons. So, that photons are receiving towards the solar panel. So, here blue color solar panel is there. Now, in the solar panel, what happened? There are too many PV cells are there. Now, that all PV cells contain the PN junction diodes. So, below that blue color, there one line of another color is shown, that is nothing but the PN junction diode. So that PN junction diode mainly helps or works for the conversation or interchanging the flow of the electrons and flow of the holes, blank holes. So in between that, the light energy, that means the photons, get converted into the electrical energy with the help of solar panel. And the solar panel will convert the electrical energy in the DC form. All of you understand? So if you want to convert that into the AC, you have to use the inverter. All of you understand? And the effect by which the sunlight get converted into the solar electrical energy, that is the DC electrical energy, that is called as a photovoltaic effect. All of you understand that? That's why I have shown you one diagram, so you will easily understand photovoltaic effect. Now we will study the theory related to the photovoltaic effect. So let's see what they have said about photovoltaic effect. The photovoltaic effect is the process that generates voltage or electric current in a photovoltaic cell when it is exposed to the sunlight. That means solar photovoltaic, first you have to understand that solar photovoltaic effect will happen when there is a sunlight, enough sunlight for the solar panel. So it will generate the voltage or current. It is this effect that makes solar panel useful, as it is how the cells within the panel convert sunlight to the electrical energy. The photovoltaic effect was first discovered in the 1839 by the Edmund Beeclers, when doing experiment involving wet cells, he noted that the voltage of the cell increased when its silver plates were exposed to the sunlight. All of you understand? That means that photovoltaic effect was first discovered in the 1839, and from that we are using the solar energy. So to convert electrical solar energy into the electrical energy, that photovoltaic effect is needed. And how that photovoltaic effect is done, that I have explained you through the diagram. Now again, see, related to that conversion of sunlight energy into the electrical energy, that is the photovoltaic effect. So the photovoltaic effects occur on the solar cell. These solar cells are composed of two different types of semiconductors, a p-types and n-types. That means all of you know, I have explained to you that solar panel contains two types of semiconductor material, p-types and n-types. They are joined together to create the p-n junction. That means both our materials are joined so that it will form the p-n junction. To read the background on what these semiconductors are and what the junction is, click here. So to that you will get the detailed idea about the p-n junction diodes. By joining these two types of semiconductor, an electrical field is formed in the region of the junction as electron moves to the positive p side and holes move to the negative n side. That means electrons moves toward the positive side, and positive side is a p-type, and holes are moving to the negative side, that is the n side. This field causes negatively charged particles to move in one direction and positively charged particle to move in the other direction. That means the electric field generated due to the p-n junction diode, it will help to move the positive charge in one direction and negative charge in the another direction. So for that purpose, p-n junction is formed over there. So let's see. The light is composed of photon. That means sunlight consists of the bunch of the photons, which are simply small bundles of electromagnetic radiation or energy. That means photons are nothing but the bunch of the electromagnetic radiation or energy. These photons can be absorbed by the photovoltaic cell. That means the photons or sunlight will incident on the solar panel, but in the solar panel photovoltaic cells are there, and that solar photovoltaic cell will absorb the photons from the sunlights. The types of the cell that composes the solar panel, when light of the suitable wavelength is incident on the cell, energy from the photon is transferred to an atom of the semiconducting materials in the p-n junction. That means when that photons are received, that will transfer the energy to the atoms of the semiconducting materials in the p-n junction. Especially, the energy is transferred to the electrons in the materials. That means that energy of the photons is transferred to the electrons in the p-n junction. This causes the electrons to jump to a higher energy state. That means that energy, once energy is transferred to the electron, that will move toward the higher energy level or higher energy state known as a conduction band. This leaves behind a hole. Once electron moves to the higher energy band, they will create the holes in the respective place. So the in the valence band, and the electron jumps up from. This movement of electron is result of the added energy create two charge carriers and electrons and holes pairs. That means electron will move to the higher energy band and it will create the holes for the new photons or for the new electrons to receive the energy from photons, and that creates the electron holes pairs and continuous electricity will be generated. Okay, when unexcited electrons hold the semiconducting materials together by forming the bonds with the surrounding atom, and thus they cannot move. However, in their excited state in the conduction band, these electrons are free to move through the materials. Because of the Because of the electrical field that exists as a result of p-n junction, electrons and holes moves in the opposite direction as expected. Instead of being attracted to the p side, the freed electrons tends to move to the n types. So free electrons will move toward the n type so that they will comes again into the holes position. This motion of the electrons create an electric current in the cell. Once the electron moves, there is a hole that is left. Once electrons take the energy from photon, it will move to the higher energy band. So at the previous position of the electrons, it will create the hole. The hole can also move but the opposite direction to the p sides. Okay, electrons move to the other side and holes will move to the other side. That means opposite to the p side, that means in the n side. It is this process which creates a current in the cells. Due to the holes and electrons are separated, it will create the current in the cells. A diagram of the respective figure I have shown you earlier in the previous slide. So let's see, I will show you that diagram. So I think all of you understand that how the solar photovoltaic effect will done. So next point we will continue in the next lecture.